You're watching BPD-TV.
Good afternoon, I'm Sergeant Anthony Smith. He's Detective Donnie Moses. Welcome to BPD-TV. Here's your daily Baltimore Police update for Monday, September 10th, 2012.
This past Friday, Stand Up to Cancer aired a nationally televised event, which so far has raised $81 million for cancer research. All of that money will go towards cancer research. This was a one-hour commercial event focusing on fighting cancer. During the broadcast, several cancer survivors were highlighted. One of those survivors is a retired Baltimore police officer. David Gobbin, from lung cancer, spread to his liver. After surviving multiple surgeries, along with therapy and radiation, he took part in a clinical trial at Johns Hopkins Hospital. Participated in a new type of therapy which works to silence the bad genes in order to jumpstart the good ones, and as a result, Gobbin's tumor shrank dramatically.
Well, BPD-TV was on hand as Stand Up to Cancer filmed his story in Baltimore as he met with old canine colleagues and reminisced about 20 years in the canine unit. We wish the best for David as he continues his fight, and we hope he can join us here one day on BPD-TV to speak about his experience. In other news, on September 8th, just after 10 p.m., a shooting occurred in the 2600 block of Kent Street in the Southern District. 38-year-old Freddie King was transported to Shock Trauma, where he died from his injuries. No motive or suspect information is known at this time.
Also on the 8th, just before 2:30 a.m., officers responded to a call for a double shooting in the 300 block of Gold Street. 28-year-old Maurice McCoy was pronounced dead at Shock Trauma a short time later, and a second victim is expected to survive as he lays in a hospital with gunshot wounds to the lower body. Homicide detectives are continuing to investigate both these incidents and are asking anyone with information to give them a call at 410-396-2100. And yes, we're still going after these bad guys with guns. Last night, just after 9 p.m., City Watch officers who were doing surveillance with the citywide camera system spotted a guy in the 2400 block of Greenmount Avenue who was displaying characteristics of someone who's armed with a gun. The City Watch officers directed patrolmen to the suspect, at which time they found a loaded Smith & Wesson .357 caliber handgun in the front dip of 21-year-old Nigel Smith. Smith was arrested and charged with various handgun violations and is now in central booking. That was great intuition by our City Watch officers. Absolutely. And great execution by the officers on the streets.
Also yesterday morning around 1:20 a.m., officers were in the 800 block of East Patapsco Avenue when they observed an unknown male beating a female on the sidewalk. As the assault continued, the suspect knocked the female to the ground and stole her purse. The suspect then attempted to flee the scene, at which time officers gave chase, while Joshua Gomes of the 4000 block of Highland Avenue was arrested and charged with unarmed robbery and assault. He's now in central booking where he's awaiting a bail review. Yesterday, September 9th, the Run to Remember was ran in downtown Baltimore. Over 1,000 runners and walkers took to the streets and trekked 5 kilometers in remembrance of the attacks of the World Trade Center. This was a phenomenal event, and we're glad everyone that went out and participated.
Absolutely. That's it for today. So, remember, follow the Baltimore Police Department on Twitter, keyword Baltimore Police, for real-time news and updates. You can watch past episodes of BPD-TV 24 hours a day by visiting our website at baltimorepolice.org.
You can also watch a rebroadcast of this program every night at 9 p.m. on Baltimore City's cable channel, TV 25. For BPD-TV, he's Donnie Moses. I'm Anthony Smith. Thank you. Have a great day.